cannot give you back your homes or restore your dead to life, but perhaps I can give you justice in the name of our king.
I've mentioned it briefly in past videos, but today I really want to talk about one species in the Game of Thrones universe that is held as mythical and non-existent. Giants. Yes, if you're caught up with Game of Thrones and or Song of Ice and Fire, you know that giants are far from just legend. But now with the death of 1-1 during the Battle of the Bastards, most fans believe that's a wrap on the intriguing race. I have my doubts, and today I want to go over everything that is known about the giants of Westeros. To start off, we know that giants roamed the lands of Westeros at the same time the Children of the Forest did, thousands of years before the first men migrated from Essos. Giants and the children would come into conflict on occasion, eventually trying to keep to themselves and live in separate areas of Westeros. As the first men came over, as well as the Andals, giants were pushed north, as the new human settlers were selfish and cared little for sharing land. This migration north has kept all the way until now, with people of the realm believing giants were long dead or just fake south of the wall. On top of that, many think giants, along with White Walkers and Children of the Forest, are just a thing of make-believe, something to tell children to keep them fearful and humble. The truth is, all of these creatures and more exist north of the wall. Giants are massive, stronger than a dozen men, and according to Ygritte, very shy. If you look at them too long, their shyness will turn to rage. Although we've only seen a few hanging around wildling camps, it is said in the books that when Mance Rayder united all of the Free Folk clans, there were hundreds of giants still living. In the show, 1-1 was the last living giant attached to the wildling camps. Just like inside Westeros, there are people and creatures who do not affiliate themselves with a certain house or fly an established banner. Giants are this way. Only a portion of them made the move to unite with humans north of the wall. You could say there is great potential for many more giants to be alive, near the lands of Always Winter. We wouldn't know because it is a place so far north of the wall, it would be a death sentence for an average wildling. Whether it's a winter storm that would kill you or a large group of wights, the areas closest to the farthest north is treacherous. To be honest, it's the perfect place for a species that is known for its bashfulness. I know one question that might pop into your mind is how could giants survive living so far into the north when White Walkers could easily turn the giants undead and add them among their ranks? Well, it's a good question, and it is possible that there are giants with icy blue skin. But remember, White Walkers are in dispute with humans for whatever reason, not necessarily giants. While we haven't seen the extent of the White Walker army and its true intentions, it could be possible the Night King doesn't care for wild giants that aren't fighting for humans. That's just my two cents. Anyway, I think it's fair to say giants have a good chance of still being around, just maybe not any that are fighting for the wildling clans and or Jon Snow. Oh, and one really interesting story I want to share real quickly is how Tormund got his nickname Giantsbane. Tormund once found himself caught in a storm north of the wall, basically a massive blizzard. He knew he was going to freeze to death unless he could find a way to build a shelter. He came upon a sleeping mother giant, whom Tormund cut into so he could survive the frigid temperatures by using her stomach as shelter. When the mother giant awoke, she thought Tormund was her child and nurtured him for 3 whole nights until he was able to escape. The reason I brought up that story is not only because it gives a great background on some of the adventure that Tormund has had in his life thus far, but it proves there are female giants, meaning giants reproduce much like regular humans do. This could have been common sense for most, but with a mythical race in a George R.R. Martin story, you never know. And it also means that new giants could be born during the current timeline, making the race less endangered than we thought. Lastly, there is a story very popular to northerners in the realm, as well as free folk beyond the wall. It is the story of the Horn of Winter, a horn that not only is theorized to be able to bring the wall down, but once woke the giants from the earth, possibly giants that were in a long hibernation state. Maybe, just maybe, there are still giants that haven't awoken from a long slumber. If that's the case, then well, who knows what might happen with the race in the future. Alright everyone, I hope you enjoyed that dialogue. I truly believe we should take more time delving into some of the prophecies and stories of long-forgotten creatures of the world. They may be more real than they get credit for. As always, have a great day, take care, and I'll see you tomorrow.